Hi there, Simon from SimonWoods.com. Slightly different situation in the house. It's Christmas Eve here, and I'm just wondering what to dig into with my turkey tomorrow. So I thought maybe a little Chardonnay. So I've got four here that I have opened. I've only opened one of them. I'm about to open the other three. What have we got? Two Australians, one South African, and one from... Well, we'll get onto that when we get onto wine number three. I've got them organised in alcohol order. There's still some people who think, oh, the Australian's about to be the highest alcohol. Well, no. I've got an Australian that we're starting with, and I've got an Australian that we're finishing with. So we're starting off at 12.5% with De Bortoli Windy Peak Yarra Valley Chardonnay 2012. Let's give this one a whirl. Smells young and Macon-y. So when I think of Macon wines, I think of a little bit of orchard fruit, for want of a better term. Apples, pears, and those apples and pears where they're ripe, but they're things like ripe Cox's apples, so there's still a little bit of bite in them. And some of them are fresh, and some of them are ever so slightly cooked. If you imagine apple Charlotte, and thinking of those apple Charlotte, the apple Charlotte, if you don't know it, it's apples baked under a layer of sponge. And where the apples meet the sponge goes a little bit clarty, thoddy, if you want a better term. There's a little smell of that, a little bit of creaminess, a little bit of nuttiness. It smells like it's going to be one of those that's lighter in body, fuller in flavour. Let's see. Yeah, crisp, young, dainty wine. One of those that's got that sappy, refreshing quality, and a bit of citrus kicks in, as well as those apples and pears. Really tasty wine. I wouldn't say we're amazingly complex, but just like a darn good glass of wine, you would hoover up your first glass, you'd get probably well halfway through the second glass and think, I might even have a third, but I'm not going to have a third. I'm going to move on to, not even going to have a second. I'm going to move on to wine number two, the one which I have opened. So this is from South Africa. The Glen, Carlou, Quartz, Stone, Chardonnay, single vineyard, wine of origin, Paarl. And there's warm Paarl, and there's cool Paarl. I imagine that this is from some of the cooler bits in Paarl, because the warmer bits would be a bit too warm for Chardonnay. So this wine weighs in at 13%. Let's give it a whirl. Now the first wine, the Windy Peak, that was a style of Chardonnay that Australia wasn't making 20 years ago. This is a style of Chardonnay that South Africa wasn't making 20 years ago. These guys, Glen, Carlou, they were one of the, I suppose, upmarket Chardonnay pioneers in South Africa. But if you look at their wines from the mid-90s, they're a bit fuller, richer and butterier. Butterier? Is that a word? It is now. Than this. Fuller, richer, does that sound like a good thing? Well, for me, Chardonnay, full and rich, isn't necessarily a positive. I prefer my Chardonnays on the leaner, sleeker side. So that's what you've got here. You've got a little bit of that creaminess and a little bit of nuttiness, fuller and creamier than the Windy Peak was. And you've got a little touch of oxidation in there. So the fruit's lost some of its perky, fresh edges, and has developed an extra layer of earthy, oxidised complexity. Does that make sense? Does to me. Anyway, better taste it. When you taste it, those richer things really come through. Things like the hazelnuts. There's a little bit of crystallised pineapple in there. Citrus freshness. There are still some of those characteristics that I notice in their wines of old, like this slightly tough, toffee, buttery, malolactic fermentation character. I almost wish that there was a little less of that, just to make it a little bit fresher and livelier as the first one was. But there'll be some people who love that style. Personally, I prefer the style of the Windy Peak, but it's a fair enough wine. I don't mind that at all. Anyway, wine number three. This is Pullus 2012 Chardonnay from Slovenia. And whereabouts in Slovenia? Oh, well, golly, my Slovenian isn't up to much, but Stajerska, is that the region? If it's not, I will report back. So we've gone up another half a degree in alcohol. We started off 12.5, then 13.5. No, sorry, 12.5, then 13, and then this one's 13.5. I stick my nose in there, and it feels like it's got probably more in common with the Windy Peak. I don't notice too much of the imprint of oak there. What I do notice is quite a simple fruitiness. Maybe a little bit of peach, a little bit of that citrus fruit, and then maybe a little bit of apple, but certainly not as much of them as there had been in the previous two wines. It smells like it's going to be a reasonable wine, but not amazingly complex. Young, fresh, simple, an oak Chardonnay. A bit of citrus zip and that just ripe nectarine coming through on the finish, which is quite pleasant. But I was talking about Macon with the first wine. Maybe if the Windy Peak is something a more ambitious Maconnais style, like Saint Véran or Puy-Fouissé, this is more in the regular Macon village, just honest, simple, tasty, simple everyday glug. And so I'm going to have another glug. It's funny, I think about that compared with the Glen Carlou. The Glen Carlou is a more complex wine. I actually think I'd probably drink more of the Pullus, but that's a personal preference. I know for some people, as I say, who it would be completely the opposite way around. Final wine, Leeuwin Estate. It's not their Art Series Chardonnay, top of the range, which has been winning them plaudits for several years, but it's their second tier Prelude Vineyards. So it's Chardonnay 2010 from the Margaret River, from their own vineyards. I'm pretty sure it's from their own vineyards. And this weighs in at 14%, so let's give this one a whirl. Now, this is more in the slightly old-fashioned Australian Chardonnay vein, but the good Australian old-fashioned vein. What's happened in Australia with Chardonnay is that there are quite a few people who've decided to rebel against the style of wines that were popular in the 80s and 90s, and picking far earlier, giving them far less oak treatment, and making a leaner, finer wine. And sometimes they're actually picking way, way too early before all the fruit flavours have developed. So you're getting something that is just too skinny. Here, I think that what's good about this is that the old-fashioned bit is it's 14% alcohol and it's ripe. The good bit about it is the way in which they've made the wine. So they've made the wine so it's not fruit-forward. There are more of these nutty, creamy, toasty characters, more the sort of thing I was getting in the Glen Carlou. But here, it feels like the winemaking is a little bit more precise. If not, let that edge of oxidation creep in. And the result is it smells complex. It's got this leasy character. As I say, the fruit slightly backward. So there's these bits of pineapple and peach, bit of the citrus in there as well to keep it fresh. And these other flavours, the flavours to do with the winemaking. So a little bit of nuttiness from the lees contact, a little bit of toastiness from the barrel. So it smells like I'm going to quite enjoy it. Let's have a go. A little bit of pineapple chunk. A little bit of fresh pineapple, peaches, peach, and there's that peach melon, but a little touch of vanilla in there from the barrel, but a crisp finish. Yes, it's that. I think this is the wine that the Glen Carlou would like to be. It's funny, the two Australian Chardonnays flanking two wines from other countries, and both the Australians are they're different in style. I like them both. And I could see myself, maybe the Windy Peak is a summer wine and the Leeuwin's a winter wine, and we're in the middle of winter here, so that's probably the one I'm going to be setting into as we test some of the Christmas recipes. But I like them both, and the ones in between weren't bad either. But for me, the Australians made a nice edge, brackets of quality around the other two, which were a little bit below, but still tasty. Hey, see you soon.